And so, my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus showed to us that he is an extraordinary person. He's different from the rest of us. He's not a magician. He's just a man of God who came from heaven to do the work of God. He had much power in him. He still does. He can perform things like this that you would never believe. I've been to many cemeteries in my life as a priest for funerals. I call it my second home. I'm always in cemeteries. And I see all these stones there, thousands of stones, quiet, nothing going on. Then, I'm saying to myself, Jesus promised that if we believed in him, we would come out of the grave. That's hard to believe. It really is hard to believe. You mean to tell me all these people that died are going to come out of the grave? My brothers and sisters, he said so, and I believe him. When we have a prayer service at a cemetery, just was this yesterday, I see the same words that come from the scriptures. I am the resurrection, I am the life. He who believes in me, even though he should die, will come back to life again. Hearing these words is not sufficient for an ordinary person to believe in. I want to see it. If you can let me see it, then I'll believe it. Well, there's the problem. I believe it because the apostles told me that they were there the day of the resurrection, and they saw Jesus come out of the grave. We know he was dead for sure, the cross wasn't alive. They didn't give him some rest and comfort for a few nights. He was dead and buried, and he rose again on the third day. You see, it's a wonderful bit of news, because in dismal, impossible situations, we tend to give up. We tend to have no hope. Think of the amount of people in our world right now that don't believe in anything, confronted with this coronavirus that looks like it's going to take over. It looks like it's going to destroy us all. But if you keep in mind that Christ is risen from the dead, they still listen to prayer. To believe that and to trust him, you have a tremendous power to spread with you. I've seen with my own eyes, on my iPad and the television, how many people are despairing. They lost their hope completely during this coronavirus crisis. They don't believe anything's going to ever happen. They will put this out of this. That's not true. It will pass, it will go away, the curve will be brought down. When? We don't know, but it will be. So what I'm saying to you as believers, don't waste your time in fear. Our Lord said, do not be afraid, he said. Do not be afraid. What does he say? Do not be afraid. I am with you. Do you believe that Christ is with you right now? I do believe it, but Lord, I want to see you do something. Get rid of this virus. You know, get rid of it. Do you think the world would believe if that came true? Maybe some would believe, others will go back to where they were living before. It won't change at all. For a lot of people, nothing changes in their lives. So if you believe, it can change your life right now. If you're in fear, if you're in despair, if you're really worried, and some of us are shaking because we're afraid this thing could get me and I'm going to die. Well, the Lord says, trust in me. Trust me. And even should it happen to me, he still said, trust in me, even if it happens. Trust in me. Trust in me. Don't be afraid. I would like to read you some consoling thoughts from Psalm 62, which is a beautiful psalm. And I say it in the cemetery, right there with the body of friend and the family. This is what I say to them from the psalm. Psalm 62, trust in God alone. Only in God is my soul at rest. From him comes my salvation. He alone is my rock and and my salvation. My stronghold, I shall not be disturbed at all. With God is my safety, my strength. He's my glory. He's the rock of my life. My refuge is in God. Trust in Him at all times, my people. Broadcast before Him. Trust in God. And that's what we need right now. He will take us out of this. It'll go. It won't be around forever. And then after that, you can test your soul and say, did I really trust in God to do this? I do believe He will bring us out of this. And no matter what happens, I'm in the best of hands, in the hands of God. And I'd like to end the simple homily with the hymn that we sing pretty much in our church anyway. And I never really paid close attention to these words, because you're sitting, you're in a procession, you're not paying attention. But listen to these words of the hymn, O God, I help in ages past. O God, I help in ages past. I hope for years to come, I shelter in the stormy blast, I return home. Beneath the shadow of your wings, your saints have felt secure. Sufficient is your arm alone, and our defense is sure. O God, I hope, in ages past, our defense is sure against this coronavirus. May God give those people who have contracted already the strength to bear the cross of this illness. It doesn't always mean that these people are going to die. Many people are surviving it. Many people are surviving it. But don't think it's the end of your life if you do contract it. In any event, in any circumstance, my consolation, my hope, my redemption, my salvation is in Christ. As these two sisters in despair lost their little Lazarus, were crying and desperate, they reached out to Jesus and said, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. I am with you. And he called Lazarus out of the desperate situation of bringing him back to life. Hope in God and trust in Him at all times. Let us now say the Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God,